Good morning, everyone. So yeah, we are very happy to host the annual Clarin conference, but also we are happy to present to you today what the Clarin, the participation of France in Clarin is going to be. So I don't know if waiting maybe for the slides. Okay, it is okay. So the participation of France is going to be led by Humanum, that will be presented to you by Nicolas Larousse, who is in charge of the participation of France in Daria, as well, and by myself. So my name is Patrice Bello. I am professor in computer science and in natural language processing in Aix-Marseille. And I am also a member of the steering committee of Humanum and of the assessment committee of Clarin. So the good news is that France has decided to become an observer in Clarin with the endorsement of the French Ministry of Research. So we hoped that we would have... We
can announce it's on the pipe, as we say in French.
Yeah, we.
And it's nearly signed.
Yeah, and we hope to have the signature today, but maybe tonight. I don't know. Yeah, it's okay. And so Humanum is a very large facility dedicated to humanities and social sciences. And in France, we also have a network infrastructure. Dedicated to language data and tools. And its name is Ortholang, and it will be presented to you by Christophe Paris just after this presentation. So the first aim for France in Clarin, of course, is to gather the already labs and structures that are involved in Clarin. We already have two C centers, and Ortholang, of course, and some labs. From the linguistics and from the NLP communities. And the objective is to have a clear roadmap to become a full member in the future. So for now, the two C centers, maybe you already know it, is the Speech and Language Data Repository. It contains some resources developed by the Laboratoire Parole et Langage in Aix-en-Provence and from the Brain and Language Research Institute that is led by Philippe Lache in Aix-Marseille too. So if you want to access to the repository, you have to follow this link. And this link is indeed a redirection to the Ortholang platform. And the second C center is Cocoon. It is also a repository for speech recordings. And it is supervised by two linguistics labs. And if you want to access to the collection, you have to go to this website on the Humanum platform. So during the conference, you can also meet some of the French labs that may or wish to become Clarin centers in the close future. And the LIMSI, the LINA, of course, our labs in Aix-Marseille, of course, also Ortholang, and you can also meet a representative of ELDA. So for the LINA, so the LINA is the computer science labs of the city of Nantes. It is represented today by Beatrice Dye. She's here. Yeah. The LINA is developing some tools or some resources dedicated to, for example, to terminology extraction or to sentiment analysis. And they developed UIMA components. You can also meet the LIMSI that develops also a lot of resources, of linguistic resources. And it is represented today by Gilles Ada, in the middle of the room. And the LIMC has two teams, one for written and signal language information processing, and the second about for spoken language processing. So these are very large team in France. You can also meet, Valérie Mapelli, who is, that's here, that represents today the ELDA, the distribution agency of ELDA for commercial activities. So now I give the floor to Nicolas to present you Humanum.
So I'm Nicolas Larousse from Humanum. What is Humanum? And in France, we know we like to have some strange acronyms. We are a very large infrastructure. What does that mean? That means that we are basically an infrastructure. We are dedicated to humanities. That means that we are more, we are not dedicated to linguistics, for instance. We take care about historian, about whatever is involved in humanities in general. And we are an infrastructure in the European sense. That means that we provide services, we provide machines, we provide that something in a data center, which is the regular infrastructure. But we think also that we need to help people to build networks of expertise. So there are the two balance between what we think is a real infrastructure. And we are a very large infrastructure because it's a term from the Ministry of France. It's not that we are very large, we are 10 people. So it's not that large. This is a term to explain that we have an anchor in Europe. There's something, we need to do something with Europe. So what do we do with Europe? We do what we have done for DARIA, for instance. We support the French participation in DARIA and we coordinate the French participation in DARIA. And this is the reason why we are also going to support the French participation in CLARIN. But in this case, it's more dedicated to linguistics. So we are going to do that with the help of the linguistic community represented by Patrice and by Christophe, with Ortolan, and by all the people that you were already mentioned. Is that clear? So the French participation in CLARIN will be held by Humanum on a political level, but on a scientific level, it will be the goal of the community. And in 2 years, we'll see if it's went well or not, and we'll see what the ministry will decide if we go again or not. Is that clear? Humanum, we have some links with outside of Europe, for instance, with the French-speaking community in Quebec. So we are going in Quebec next week, for instance. A part of Humanum is going to Quebec next week, and with South America to deal with some resources in Spanish. Just, I have 3 minutes left, so I'm going to try to explain what we are doing in Humanum because it's not that clear maybe for you. So we have a sort of onions of things that we are doing in Humanum. In the center of the onion, you have people, and these people are network project, researchers, engineers, and they want to use services. And just above this kind of people, we have consortia. I will explain what is a consortia, but there is one which is specialized in linguistics, for instance. And consortia, you mean you put people interested in the same object, in the same theme, and you support them, we funded them. And we expect these people to do some work about good practices, tools, whatever they want. And after that, we expect that to have synergies between what we are doing and what these people are doing, and to share tools. This is the case, for instance, for a tool which name is OpenTeso. It's to deal with thesaurus in Scores. So this is the idea that Humanum is not only a bunch of machines in a data center. We try to support communities as well. And we have services, we have a data center, we are hosted in a data center from people who are doing real science, they say. You know, it's not like soft science, humanities, and art science, physics, and so on. So we are in a big data center. We it's really comfortable for us because we don't need to buy electricity network and so on. It's already there. And you see the rest of the onion is about Europe. So Humanum wants to be the hub from the French humanities community to go to Europe. That means that we help people to show their work in Europe, that we are doing, for instance, in Partenos. And we expect from Europe to get some input or some feedback about what we are doing and to enhance what we are doing. A short description of Humanum Consortia. We have 10 consortia, and sometimes it's disciplinary, music, for instance. Sometimes it's not disciplinary at all, 3D. You know that linguistic is more disciplinary, but we support groups of people, generally speaking, 20 people from different structures in France, which is nice because normally people in France doesn't speak together if they are not in the same structure. So I have only 1 minute left. I switch to services. And in Humanum, we offer two types of services. You see on the left, they are really regular, classical services. That means that we provide hosting, we provide a lot of software and so on. And on the left, we have a bunch of services, a chain of services, which aims at preserve and share and reuse data. That means that we provide some tools for people to preserve data, document them with metadata, show them with Isidore, and preserve them on the long term. And I can finish that the first data that we preserve on a pilot project was data from the linguistic, from Cocoon and SLDR. I'm finished.